all workers. But he's like a father, so. We moved here in 72, Larry became, like I said, a mentor to a lot of people here. And one story I always talk about is my brother and I, Larry, right up the hill from us, lived on Hunt Street. Brother and I go up one morning, Saturday or Sunday, we always wait until about 9:30, 10 o'clock to go play basketball. So we're sitting up there, we're playing, we got maybe 5 minutes into the game, and back door opens up, Larry walks down in boxers, grabs the basketball, back in the house and went. Brother and I looked at each other for a minute, definitely go knock on the door, we walk back to the house. Fast forward 2 weeks, Larry comes down the patrol car, says, Kevin, I haven't seen you in a couple weeks playing ball. I said, Larry, I don't have a basketball anymore. Let me go get that. Went up to the house and brought it back to the patrol car. That was Larry. What I didn't know at the time was that APD at the time was doing 28 days on first shift, 28 days on third shift. Well, Larry had just switched to third shift, so I guess it wasn't a good idea. He just got off at 6 in the morning, and he was a little tired. Third 2 years going into the service, every time I came home, Larry made it a point to come see me, and vice versa. Whether it be going to the police department, going to his house, he made it a point because Larry truly cared about everyone. If he asked you how you were doing, he meant it. It was genuine, and you knew it. And that was, and I thank Larry, and it's forgiven. Now, I say to you today, my friends, even though we face the difficulties of today and tomorrow, I still have a dream. It is a dream deeply rooted in the American dream. I have a dream that one day this nation will rise up and live out the true meaning of its creed. We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal. That is Larry. To the hill. Thank you.
I think he made it a point every day when he came into work, he tried to talk to everybody. Ask him how the day was. He just didn't come in, get his stuff, and go. He actually tried to talk to everybody that was there, and he cared about everybody else but himself. You know, we'd always ask, do you need anything? Nope, I'm good. But he was always there for us. I went through a loss of a mother and a sister over the last few years, and he was there. He came to the services for me, personally as a friend. Even after he retired, he would always come into the township at least once or twice a week just to check on us. That was Larry. He would go out of his way to help people. There was one of the public works people didn't have coverage, so he came in and took water samples for the weekend so they could have off to be with